that's the car. What was left of it after the accident. If it was an accident. Hannaford, before he changed his mind, was going to give the car to the young leading actor of his last movie, John Dale. And Hannaford was supposed to have saved him at some earlier date from committing suicide. Or so the story goes. As for his own death, his admirers were sure that Hannaford did not intend to drive the car off that bridge. A corny ending, they said. J.J. Hannaford would never be guilty of that. But there were other opinions. He died many summers ago, July 2nd. For years, I personally didn't want this document shown because, frankly, I didn't like the way I came off in the piece. But I'm old enough now not to care anymore how my role in Jake's life is interpreted. My name is Brookes Otterlake, probably Hannaford's most successful acolyte. Anyway, this little historical document has been put together from many sources, from all the footage shot by TV and documentary filmmakers, and also the students, critics, and young directors who happened to bring 16 and 8 millimeter cameras, having been invited to Jake's 70th birthday party. That was long before cell phone cameras and computerized images. The choice of this material was an attempt to sketch a film likeness of the man himself as he looked through all those different viewfinders. Hannaford's own unfinished last motion picture is part of this testimony, The Other Side of the Wind. It has been left just as it was when they showed it at his party on what turned out to be the last day of his life.